Hello everyone, this is CS Manisha Sharma and I welcome you all to my channel Professionalism. In this video, we will discuss about the form MGT7A that is also known as abridged annual return for small companies and OPC companies. MCA wide notification dated 5th of March 2021 introduced a new form of annual return exclusively for OPC company and a small company, and that new form is MGT7A. Prior to this amendment, every company, whether it is a private company, public company, small company, OPC company, every company is required to file its annual return under Section 92 of Companies Act 2013 with the Registrar of Company in form MGT7, and that is required to be filed within 60 days from the date of the AGM of the company. But after this amendment, MCA introduced a new form, that is Form 7A, for OPC and small company for filing its annual return. What is Form MGT7A? MGT7A is an abridged or condensed form of annual return, and this return has been introduced by Companies Amendment and Administration Rule 2021 and applicable with effect from 5th of March 2021. The main purpose behind the introduction of this form MGT7A is to reduce the compliance burden for small company and OPC company. So what about the insertion of abridged annual return form in MGT7A? As we already discussed, that every company that is registered in India, whether it is a private, OPC or a small company, was required to file its annual return in form MGT7. But now, as per the Companies Amendment and Administration Amendment Rule 2021, every company shall file its annual return in form MGT7, except one person company and a small company. As from the financial year 2021 onwards, in MCA, the MGT7A has been introduced, and one person company and a small company has to file its annual return in form MGT7A instead of MGT7. When we are talking about the applicability, the form is applicable from the financial year 2021 onwards, and you have to check the status whether your company is falling under the definition of a small company or not as on 31st March 2021, not as on the date of filing of the form. Regarding certification, MGT7 is not required to be certified by the practicing company secretary. It can be filed with the DSC of a directors only. Due date of MGT7A. The due date of MGT7A is 60 days from the date of the AGM of a company. Suppose if the date of AGM is 30th September, then the last date for filing MGT7A will be 29th November. There is a slight difference between form MGT7A and MGT7, as MGT7A is a simplified form where certain details are not required to be filled up. These details are as date of AGM, particulars of associate companies like holding and subsidiary company, details of unclassified share capital, breakup of share capital, details of shares and debenture transfer, shareholding pattern, members and other meeting details, details of board meeting, attendance of a director. So these details are not required to be mentioned in form MGT7A, but these details are required to be filled up in form MGT7. So this is about form MGT7A. We have discussed about the brief details of MGT7A, and in our next video we will going to discuss about the live demo, that how we have to file form MGT7A, that what are the details we have to mention in form MGT7A, and what will be the attachments. So all these we will discuss in our next video. Thank you, hope you like it.